What's up, guys and girls? This is going to be the fourth tutorial in the auto layout project series, and in this one we are going to see how a table is made using the auto layout feature of Figma. So for table, first of all we need one clarity. Okay, so in our previous video we started designing this specific screen. We are already done with the top bar. Now we are moving forward to the table. So for tables, there is one thing you need to consider first before starting to design a table. A lot of people start designing tables by column, or you know, first define one column and then the other and then the other. Or you can do that by defining rows. It all depends on the position of the header of that table. If the header of your table lies in each row, then it would be better to define your table row by row. But in this specific case, the headers are on top of each column, so it would be wise to define this table column by column. All right, so first of all, what I'm going to do is I'm going to define one auto layout frame for the header and then one for the cell, like each cell that is going to be repeated again and again. All right, so let's get started. So this is going to be, alright, let's just type header and define an auto layout frame. We need the color. I'm going to take this color, and yeah, our header is ready. Okay, so one more thing, when we define a frame and the only thing inside that frame is a text, the text itself has the properties of auto layout. I can also click on fill container and it will adjust the bounding box of that text, will adjust according to the width of that defined frame. As you can see, the bounding box of the text was filled in according to the width of that auto layout frame. Okay, so what I'm going to do is I'm going to define it as a component and name it header, and then I'm going to make, let's just call it lorem ipsum text, oops, and I'm going to make another component. I just pressed Ctrl Alt K, or you can use this button as well, and now this is my cell. Alright, now for cell, we can see that text size is bigger, and the padding at the top and the bottom is much more as compared to the header. So I'm going to give it a 16 padding at both sides, top and bottom, and that's it. We have defined our header and a cell. Now I'm going to use these two to start forming my table. Okay, first of all, what I'm going to do is select both of them, press Shift A to make an auto layout frame, and then remove the padding between these, 0, and that's it. Now this is my first column. I can just select the first cell and press Command D or Control D, and you can see that it is going to fill in multiple tables row by row. So our first column is ready, but the main feature of the auto layout is the responsiveness, and it's not responsive yet because the cells and the header is not defined to fill the container that it lies in. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to select the defined cells and headers and press this fill container. Now if you grab the column and move it around, you can see that the cells inside that particular column are going to fill in according to the width of that table. Right, so our first column is ready, which was, oops, what are those? We don't need that. Alright, so for the sake of this tutorial, we are just going to create a simple table where we don't have these status bars and different icons in that cell. But for now, we are just designing a table using auto layout. So what I'm going to do is duplicate this column, select both of them, press Shift A, and remove the space between them. Second column is ready, and the third and fourth and fifth. I just pressed Command D or Control D, and it will do the job. So we had 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 columns. We need 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. One more. Okay, it's done. Now you can see, okay, you can't see that because I haven't done one specific thing. Okay, so we had defined that whenever this specific column changes, the cells inside would fill in this space according to the width of that specific column. But when I select this whole table and try to, you know, change it, it doesn't happen. Why not? Because now the main frame is this one, table, and then we have column 1, column 2, column 3, and blah blah blah. So now we have to select each of these columns and click on fill container. Now if I change the width of the whole table, you can see that all the columns inside that specific table are going to be adjusted according to the width of my defined table. And one more thing that I defined in the beginning of the tutorial about the text bounding box. Now why did I specify that thing? Because if we minimize the width of that whole table, you can see there comes a point when it changes. The text inside all of these cells were defined to fill the container. So if I select one of these cells, you can see that the bounding box is also moving according to the cell that it lies in. So that was one main important point that should be considered while making a table using auto layout. Alright, so one last thing that is remaining is the line beneath all these cells. Now there are a number of ways you can do that. One would be, as I have already defined a cell here, I can just press on this one and define a stroke. Oh, okay, that's not stroke. That one is. Just the top one, and the color would be this. And boom, easy. And for the whole table, if you want this stroke, you can do that by just pressing this. Click outside, and again, we need the same color again, and boom, easy. So that's how we create a table using auto layout. There are a lot of ways we can do that by defining either columns and rows. I just did one using simple cells and headers for sake of this specific tutorial. In the next one, we are going to see how we can introduce these different cells in my defined table. So yeah, that's it for this tutorial. I'll be back soon with the next one. Stay tuned. Bye.